a company which has a very wide presence across the globe, a company whose 48% of the sale comes only from Asia, and that is why maybe it stands true for its name, Asian Paints. Har ghar kuch kehta hai. I hope by now you might be aware that I have already started memberships on my channel. In one of the categories of membership, which is termed as the Pro Investor category, I have given a feature that you are going to get a stock of the month analysis. I saw some comments on my channel wherein my subscribers told me that please give us an example of how the stock of the month analysis would look like. So here's an example for you in which I'm going to analyze Asian Paints, which would be like the stock of the month analysis. Those who already have subscribed for memberships, a separate stock of the month analysis is going to come up for you in the first half of February. So just check this out. Hi guys, CA Rachana Ranade here, and I welcome you all to my second lecture on fundamental analysis, which is a long FA series having part 1 and part 2. Today we are going to talk about all the basics of Asian Paints, including its strategy, the management, the different products that it has launched, some fun facts about Asian Paints as well. As I mentioned in the first part of the video, it has a very wide presence all across the globe. As you can see on the map, it has presence in Egypt, Ethiopia, Bahrain, UAE, Oman, Nepal, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, of course India, Singapore, Indonesia, Solomon Islands, Vanuatu, Fiji, Samoa, Tonga. I'm sure some of you are actually listening to these names for the very first time. When I was doing research, same was the case for me, right? So it has presence across so many countries. And if you talk about how much revenue they are getting from the international operations, see why India was not covered here, because this entire graph is only about international operations, right? So for that, Asia accounts for almost 48% of their sales. Africa is 20%, Middle East, Oman, Bahrain, UAE, all that 26%, and South Pacific accounts for 6% of the sale. If you ask about what are the international operations, what are the various brands through which they operate, here you can see a lot of brands through which Asian Paints operates. Have a close look at these brands. Is something bothering your mind? And what is that? Berger Paints? Daya? Kya ho gaya? How is Asian Paints and Berger? I mean, what is Berger Paints doing in Asian Paints? In fact, I can see Asian Paints and Berger together. What is happening? Is there some flaw in her research? No, there is no flaw in my research. Even I was very surprised when I saw this for the very first time. Then I did a lot of research. Me and my research team actually sat on the same point as to why Berger Paints is coming. By the way, this is an image which I have captured from the annual report of Asian Paints. And this image was actually a bit confusing, because Berger Paints, which is IDL, its competitor, finds a place in its annual report. Okay, so then we try to find out what is this Berger. So Berger is basically a surname, okay, and Berger Paints, which was the main company, the Berger Paints company, which was promoted by Lewis Berger. Okay, so Lewis Berger is a different company. So even if you check out the logo of the Indian Berger Paints, just have a careful look at the logo. B is in capital and rest other letters are in small font, whereas this one, which you can see in the annual report, see the entire thing is in caps. So Asian Paints holds 96.84% shares in Berger Paints Singapore. So in short, Berger Paints Singapore is completely different from Berger Paints India. I also did to do a promoter cross-check, and I found this, that promoters of both these companies are totally different. Let's understand a little bit about history of Asian Paints. In 1942, during the World War, what happened in India was there was a ban which was introduced for importing paints. That was seen as a very good opportunity by some businessmen in India. Mr. Champaklal Choksi, who is one of the founder members of Asian Paints, saw this as a very good business opportunity, and he started Asian Paints in a very small garage in Mumbai. He was also accompanied by two of his another friends. So the total promoters who started this company was Choksi, Dani and Vakil. This trio traveled a long journey together, wherein they had started at a very small garage by the name Asian Oil and Paints Company Private Limited. That was done in 1942. After a long span, in 1965, they changed the name of the company to Asian Paints Limited. In short, the company, which was initially started as a private limited company, now became a public limited company. Just for your information, if I'm talking about a private limited company, you cannot have more than 200 shareholders. The moment you have the 201st shareholder, it is mandatory as per the Companies Act that you get yourself converted as a public limited company. That is what happened in 1965. What happened was, after being converted into a public limited company, they started to grow more, they started to do more and more of expansion. But initially, all the distributors were not giving them a damn. Many distributors ignored to accept the distributorship of Asian Paints. After a lot of struggle, the very first distributor in Sangli, Maharashtra, had agreed to take up their distributorship. This was just the start point. And you know what is rest is history. A Bollywood hero can become a superstar overnight. But I personally feel that success is not determined by one movie. It is determined by how the hero performs over his career span. He has to strategize for his acting. He has to strategize on the choice of movies he selects to be featured in. Similarly, a company can start with a bang wherein it can innovate a very nice product in the beginning. I can say example is BlackBerry. But if it fails to adapt to the new technological environment or the overall environment, then comes a very big problematic scenario. So what happened with Asian Paints was that initially, when all the other paint companies were mainly focusing on big containers of paints, Asian Paints was struggling a little bit in the beginning to find out its own space, to make its own name. So they tried to strategize. The promoters tried to strategize. They tried to understand that where can we enter into a typical area where no one is actually concentrating. So in Maharashtra, there is a separate festival known as Bail Pola, and in South, it is celebrated like Pongal. During this festival, the horns of cows and buffaloes are painted with bright color. This was seen as an opportunity by Asian Paints, wherein they said that these people don't need a full container of paint. They actually need small containers. So that's why they introduced all these small containers of colorful paints, which will make the cows and buffaloes look much prettier. So this was a very new strategy that they moved ahead with. In a span of approximately 10 years, they crossed a turnover of 23 crores. Understand, it's not 23 crores of today. We are talking about 1950s and 1960s. That's a big turnover in that time. In 1967, in a matter of 25 years from inception, Asian Paints became India's largest paint manufacturing company. After achieving this milestone, they felt that now we should not stick to our promoter group, Choksi Dani Vakils. They felt that now we should hire more and more of professionals who can bring more of professionalism into the business and who can take the business to a next level. This is where they thought of hiring the best in town or the best in the country talent. They hired them, and in fact Asian Paints are considered as the paymasters. Just to give you an example, I had a word with my fellow CA friends. They told me that where a 3 to 4 years CA, if he can get a package of 12 lakhs in industry, Asian Paints would easily offer roughly around 20 lakhs. So they are that's why I called as the paymasters. They pay more for talent, and that is where they believe that we can go to the next level. Believe it or not, they have also been focusing a lot on technology since 1974. 1974 was the year when they brought the first mainframe computer, which was used for R&D and for data analysis. We talk about data analysis in 2020. Still, there are so many people who don't even talk a lot about data analysis. Right? These days, last 2-3 years, the importance has been increasing. You can imagine this is what they had brought the mainframe computer for in 1974. You can understand the love for technology, how they used it so effectively to grow their business. But the question is, what are they doing right now? Right now, they have implemented something known as SAP H4HANA. And they have implemented this SAP H4HANA. It's nothing but an ERP, Enterprise Resource Planning software, across all the companies over the globe. So I'll show you in the very first slide as to where all Asian Paints has its presence. In all these different companies all across the globe for Asian Paints, they have implemented the same software. And what is the use of this software? This software has benefited them for optimization and for resource allocation. So when I tried to study about the overall strategy of Asian Paints, I found two major points. Number one, focus was on product development, and number two was focus on technology. I did talk about how they talked about product development for the Pongal and for the Bail Pola festival, but let's understand what are the new products that they are inventing right now or in the last 3-4 years. As I mentioned in the previous segment, that product innovation is one of their key areas. Let's understand what are the latest products that they have brought into the market. The very first thing is they have brought an anti-asthma paint. When I read about this, I was really surprised. Like, those who are asthmatic patients, they know that the paint, the odor or the smell itself is very strong. Those who have asthma problems, it's very difficult for them to actually stay in a room which is newly painted. So bringing a totally new variant, which is anti-asthmatic, so I think that's a very new innovation. Second thing that they have got is anti-corrosive paint. Why anti-corrosive paint is required is that, I'll give you a simple example. With more and more of newer technology coming into the telecom sector especially, fiber optic cables are mainly used for 4G technology and onwards. More and more technology enhancements is going to lead to more and more of fiber optic cables. Now, where is this fiber optic cable laid down? It is laid sometimes beneath the earth, I mean beneath the land surface. Sometimes it travels even beneath the sea. Okay, so now you can imagine a wire which is traveling beneath the sea can easily get corroded. To have an anti-corrosion effect, Asian Paints came up with an anti-corrosion paint which has to be applied on the wire. Okay, and if such a paint is applied on the wire, then automatically what happens, even if it is with inside the water for X number of years, it doesn't get any kind of rust. So that's a biggest benefit for such an anti-corrosive paint. Next one is the natural paint that they brought. They brought more organic components into this. I feel organic is the buzzword. Organic vegetables. You are ready to pay like one and a half times extra. And do you really check whether it's organic or not? But what do we say? No, we buy only organic foods, right? So like these people can also say that we have all organic paint in our house, right? So maybe to cater to this segment of the society, they came up with a natural paint. So all in all, I feel that they have focused a lot on R&D, that is research and development, to bring newer and newer products to the market. Now let's talk about something. Again, we always must have something extra. We should go that one extra mile. That's why we are going to talk not only about history or not only about strategy, not only about products. Let's go into a little bit of hardcore finance and let us understand how GST impacted Asian Paints. When GST was introduced, it was a very, very big plus point for those who were in the organized sector. I guess in one of my previous videos on Domino's Pizza, I had talked about the same concept of organized versus unorganized. And there was a comment which in which one of the viewers had asked that, what do you exactly mean by unorganized sector? Okay, so basically unorganized sector is all the small shopkeepers. Okay, everyone is working individually. They don't have any network. Okay, like in Pune, or in all these Punekars basically, they love to write this sentence outside their shop. Amchi kothe hi shakha nahi. They take pride in saying that we don't have any branch offices, which should not be the case. But that's how we take a pride in stating that this is the only shop that we have. Okay, the shop we have. So that's like an unorganized sector. Everyone has an own, as has one shop. It's not a big company as such. So that's like an unorganized sector. Okay, but an organized sector is a big company having multiple branches. That I can say is like you fall into the organized sector category. Now what happened was, there is an impact of GST credit. I have done a separate video on basics of GST in which I have talked about the concept of GST credit. I'm going to give you the link in the I button. Do check out that video. After you watch this entire video, then you have to go back and check out that GST video, okay? But understand, when this GST credit impact was allowed only to organized sector, one of the biggest beneficiaries in the paint segment was Asian Paints. Okay, so big positive when GST was introduced, one of the biggest beneficiaries was Asian Paints, number one. Number two, GST rate was dropped from 28% to 18%. What is the advantage? For them, the basic product can become cheap. So for example, if the paint is at 100 rupees basic price and originally let us say GST was at the rate of 28%, then their basic selling price itself would have been 128. But if GST is dropped, automatically what happens? Now the product can be sold at 100 plus 18, that is 118. So automatically the product becomes cheaper. If the product becomes cheaper, it is affordable to more and more people. Obviously demand will pep up, right? The last impact of GST was a little bit negative on Asian Paints. There is a concept of destocking, believe it or not, it's way too complicated. But just understand it in this way, that when the GST was brought down from 28% to 18%, there was a lot of admin process which was to be done by Asian Paints and similar other paint companies. These companies actually had to work so much for this admin process that in fact their sales got hampered. That was the reason when in the previous year, 2019 financial year, their sales had in fact dropped because of this destocking concept. But in year financial year 20, now they are getting back on track with all this destocking effect getting over. Now they are back on track with sales. Asian Paints is now expanding into all the possible horizons. This is basically try to develop yourself in all the related areas. Once any bakra, I mean, once any customer comes to your shop, ensure that you don't allow him to go with empty hands. Ensure that he or she takes something from your shop and then only leaves your shop. That's what Asian Paints is targeting right now. For example, if a customer comes and asks, I want to buy paints. Asian Paints says, of course, we are here. Someone is interested in bathing solutions. Yes, yes, bath fittings, we are here. Someone says, we want to have nice, fancy kitchen trolleys. Don't worry, we are here. Oh my God, what are they all into? They have started with kitchen solutions, with bath fittings, interior painting, exterior painting, wall covering, adhesive. Oof, adhesive means now they're going to have a competition for even Pidilite. Pidilite is basically Fevicol. Okay, Fevicol is one of the brands which is promoted by Pidilite. And even in waterproofing solutions. In short, I can say that if I'm talking about the entire construction sector, they're almost covering a lot of area. Only Asian Paints in itself is covering a lot of area in the construction sector. Just keep this in mind. In budget, okay, important tip for you. In budget, if a good boost is given by the government for construction sector, logically, can I say Asian Paints can be a beneficiary? Because if construction sector is given a boost, automatically demand for paints will increase, demand for bath fittings is going to increase, demand for kitchen trolleys is going to increase, exterior paints, interior paints, adhesive, everything. So that is where I can feel that Asian Paints can be a good gainer if a boost is given by the government in this budget for construction related activities. Let's talk about an amazing fun fact of Asian Paints. When I was reading their annual report, I was even amazed while reading that fact. It was written that typically if Diwali, all the tithis come on different dates, then it's an elongated Diwali and then the sales for Asian Paints will be high. I was like, what? How does the tithi and the sale matter? So it's something like this. For those who know that Vasu Baras is like 12th day, Dhanat Trayodashi, Trayodashi is like 13, Narak Chaturdashi, Chaturdashi is like 14, Lakshmi Pujan is like the Amavasya, then Padwa is like Padwa number 1, then Bhau Beez, Beez is like 2. Okay, so ideally, all these 7 different festivals of Diwali itself should ideally fall on 7 different tithis, that is on 7 different days. But sometimes these tithis combine and Trayodashi and Chaturdashi would also fall on the same day. If that happens, then what happens is that the Diwali festival itself is reduced from 7 days to 3 days or 4 days also. Then what happens is that the Diwali vacation is short. If the Diwali vacation is short, then people would not bother to paint their houses during this small short span of holiday. But then you can visualize that if all the tithis fall on 7 different days, on top of that, if there is a bhakkad in between, it's not aise dhakkad hai, dhakkad hai, not that dhakkad, it is bhakkad. Bhakkad means there is no festival. Okay, so like Narak Chaturdashi and there's no festival on the immediate next day. So now the vacation gets elongated. Now what happens in this case is that, let's say there's an 8-day Diwali vacation. Now people might feel that we have an 8-day vacation. It has been a long time since we have painted our house. Let's paint our house this Diwali. Why not? Okay, so this was an amazing fun fact wherein Asian Paints had written that our sales is generally increased if the Diwali holiday is an elongated one. When they had given their annual report for the year ended 19, they said that during the financial year 18-19, the Q3 results, the Q3 sales had dropped because the Diwali vacation was shorter. So that was an amazing fun fact for you all. I hope you have gained a lot of knowledge, a lot of insights about Asian Paints. I hope you are enjoying this part 1, part 2 FA series, because understand, the moment I am restricted to 15 minutes video, I wouldn't have been able to tell you so much information about Asian Paints. And I believe that if I increase the level of sharing of knowledge, even my knowledge increases. So, hum bolte na ki khushi baatne se badhti hai. Similarly, knowledge baatne se badhta hai. So, more and more knowledge I give to you all, I feel even my knowledge increases. So, that's the way, that was the reason why I've started with part 1, part 2 series. in the last week, I had done a similar part 1, part 2 for Jubilant Foodworks. It's there in the I button. If you have not watched that video, please have a look at it. I feel I have tried my level best to give you loads and loads of information about that company as well. I hope you are enjoying the series. Do let me know in the comment section if you are liking part 1, part 2 concept or not. That's it from my side. In the next video, we are going to talk about the entire financials, the global impact, the key external factors which are going to impact Asian Paints, and a lot of stuff packed in the part 2 of the video as well. That's it from my side for the day. Jai Hind. Bye-bye.